Sara Giselle. ¿Ya te pregunté?
Yes, teacher.
Sofía Velasco.
Yes, teacher.
Okay, the third one. Sofía, how can I get better grades? ¿Sabes qué significa grades?
¿De cuál es la
La
tercera?
tercera, excellent, yes. Grades.
¿Grados?
No, grades son notas. ¿Listo?
Ah, no, no
Entonces,
sabía.
¿cómo puedo conseguir mejores notas? How can I get better grades? Entonces, Sofía, which one of those? ¿Cuál de las dos? Have you talked about to join a study group? Or it might be a good idea to join a study group.
¿Alguna de las dos es la correcta?
Yes, one of those. Entonces, how about or it might be a good idea to join a study group? Which one, Sofía?
Déjamelo pensar un momento.
Okay, think it, think it. That's my dog. Hey, Julian, good. Okay, Sofía, time is up. Tell me, how about or it might be a good idea to?
It might be a good idea.
Excellent. 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 Entonces, mucho ojo, cuando es it might be a good idea. Me va a aparecer siempre el tú, ¿verdad? Que lo estoy señalando aquí más que todo, ¿verdad? Siempre me va a aparecer un tú.
Yes.
Cuando yo utilizo about, véalo aquí, entonces, how you thought about o what about, como me sale en la primera, siempre utilizo el ing, mírenlo aquí. ING, el gerundio, ¿listo? Entonces, no digo to participate, digo participating, ¿listo? Ese es el dato clave aquí que tenemos que tener muy claro. Entonces, very good, Sofía, Sara, Karen, already answered. Julian, the fourth one. Entonces, la cuarta. What can I do to save money? Save money. Ahorrar dinero. What can I do? ¿Qué puedo hacer? Entonces, two options. Why don't you come up with a budget? Why don't you come up with a budget? Or what about come up with a budget? Entonces, ¿cuál de las dos, Julian, in the chat? Julian. What about, será Julian? Recuerda que aquí tiene que estar con ing y el verbo está normal. O sea que, ¿con cuál sería? Entonces, Julian, ¿cuál sería? Escríbela ahí en el chat. En el chat. Why don't you? Okay. Very good. Why don't you come up with a budget? Why don't you come up with a budget? Entonces, I don't see José. José is not here. So I will ask again Karen Sofía, otra pregunta. How can I get along with my roommate better? ¿Se acuerdan que era get along with? Karen Sofía.
No.
Get along with, llevarse bien con. Entonces, how can I get along with my roommate better? Entonces, ¿cómo me puedo llevar mejor con mi compañero de cuarto? Entonces, Karen, why don't you planning fun activities to look forward to every week? Or have you talked about planning fun activities to look forward to every week? ¿Cuál de las dos?
Have you talked about?
Excellent. Excellent, Karen. Excellent. Very good. Very good, guys. We have finished. Everyone has a really good grade for participation here in this activity. Let's continue. We had a lot of things. Now, another audio. Now we see this expression. All you have to do is. What does this mean? ¿Qué significa? What does this mean? All you have to do is. Sara, what means all you have to do is? Sara?
Yes, teacher.
What means all you have to do is? Okay, Sofía. Sofía Velasco.
Sure.
What means, ¿qué significa? What means all you have to do is?
¿Cómo así? No entiendo.
¿Qué significa all you have to do is?
¿Tú tienes esto?
No. Vamos a ir parte por parte.
¿Lo que está en el título?
Sí. Yes. What means? Okay, no. So, vamos parte por parte. All. ¿Qué significa all? Lo escribí ahí.
Todo lo que tienes que hacer, no sé.
Exactly. All you have. Eso le iba a decir. Todo, all es todo.
Lo que tienes que hacer.
You have. Entonces, tú tienes. Y to do is, que hacer es. Entonces sería todo lo que tienes que hacer es. ¿Listo? All you have to do is, todo lo que tienes que hacer es, o sea, es muy sencillo. ¿Por qué? Porque con esta expresión que la utilizan mucho en inglés, ustedes van a dar sugerencias cuando quieran. Entonces, por ejemplo, y les dicen, man, I'm sad. Estoy triste. Entonces dice, all you have to do is make exercise. Todo lo que tienes que hacer es hacer ejercicio. ¿Listo? Entonces vamos a escuchar el audio y vamos a ver las diferentes sugerencias que nos van a dar. Pero no solo eso. Karen, ¿puedes ayudarme a leer donde dice, hey, listen to people?
Listen to people give different suggestions for each problem. Put a link through the suggestions that was not given.
Okay, put a line, okay? Put a line through the suggestion that was not given. O sea, que la sugerencia que no dieron, todos ustedes la van a escribir ahí y van a decir, profe, de la primera, how to overcome shyness, ¿qué significa? How to overcome shyness, ¿cómo superar qué? What is shyness? Lo voy a escribir ahí en el chat. ¿Qué es Chinese? What is Chinese?
Chinese.
Chinese. Está ahí en el chat. What is Chinese, guy? Shyness means, significa timidez.
Timidez.
Timidez. Entonces, how to overcome shyness? ¿Cómo superar la? ¿La qué?
Timidez.
Timidez. Entonces, hey, la primera. Hey, read a self-help book. ¿Qué significa? Read a self-help book. Libro de autoayuda. Join a club. Join a club. See a therapist, maybe. See a therapist. Or, in some cases, take medication. ¿Listo? Take teacher, a medication.
¿Puede ser la A o la C?
Ok, listo. Vamos a escuchar en el audio cuáles dan y ustedes van a señalar cuáles dice y cuáles él no dice. ¿Listo? El del audio. Vamos a la segunda. How to start bidding. ¿Quién me puede decir qué es? A ver, Karen, the second one, what does this mean? Karen Sofía, how to stop bidding? Karen. Ok. Entonces, aquí se refiere a cómo evitar biting your fingernails. Entonces, cómo evitar morderse las que, cuando estoy azarado, las uñas. Entonces, hey, count instead. Entonces, cuenta en vez de comérselas. Entonces, cuenta 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, sí. O en inglés, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Second one, wear gloves. Guantes, gloves. Entonces, no vas a poder bite your fingernails. Paint your nails. Entonces, paint. Entonces, ¿qué es paint? Cuando yo cojo con el esmalte. Paint.
Pintar.
Excellent. Pintar. Or, I think the most reasonable is figure out why you're nervous. Entonces, busca por qué estás nervioso. ¿Listo? Figure out why you're nervous. And Karen came back. Third one. How to organize your busy schedule. ¿Cómo organizar tu qué? Tu schedule, tu horario. Entonces, A, program your phone. Entonces, program your phone. In your phone, you can program your alarm. Second one, make a list of priorities. Entonces, prioridades. C, cancel appointments. ¿Qué es un appointment? Por ejemplo, I go to the doctor.
¿Entrevista?
Una cita. ¿Listo? I go to the doctor appointment. Voy a la cita del doctor. And D, talk to a consultant. Entonces, háblale a alguien que maneje horarios, que sea un consultant y te pueda ayudar, te pueda dar consejos. ¿Listo? Ya les leí las tres. Vamos a escuchar el audio. Y vamos a, como le digo, señalar cuáles están y cuáles no están. Ok, aquí estamos. Audio.
Okay. Page 61, Exercise 9,
¿Escuchando?
Grammar Focus. Making suggestions. With modals plus verbs.
Maybe you could go to a chat room.
With gerunds.
What about taking a dance class? Have you thought about asking your friend?
Are you listening?
Yes.
Okay.
Friends to introduce you to their other friends?
With negative questions.
Why don't you join an online dating service?
Why don't you join an online dating
service? With infinitives.
One option is to join a club. It might be a good idea to check out those discussion groups at the bookstore.
It might be a good idea.
And listening. Okay. All you have to do is part A. Listen to.
Listo, aquí es. Van a escuchar y van a señalar cuáles son las que dan y cuáles son las que no dan, cuáles no recomiendan.
Two people give different suggestions for each problem. Put a line through the suggestion that was not given. 1. How to overcome shyness.
Well, I think if you're really shy, it might be a good idea to see a therapist or someone like that. You know, to get some professional help. You can't always change by yourself.
Or how about getting one of those self-help books from the library? I'm sure there are books around with lots of good suggestions that you can try.
I think the best thing is to join a club and do activities where you have to meet and talk to different people. Like, if you join a theater group and work on putting on a play, you'll probably be able to overcome your shyness.
Okay, entonces, which one? A. Was mentioned or not? Mencionado o no? Read a self-help book.
Yes.
Yes. B. Join in a club.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. C. See a therapist.
Yes.
And D. Take medication.
No.
No. Excellent. Excellent. Sarah, I think.
Two.
Second one.
How to stop biting your fingernails.
How to stop biting your fingernails.
I think biting your fingernails is just a sign of anxiety. So the first thing to do is to find out what's making you nervous. Once you've identified that problem and then solved it, the nail biting will disappear.
My sister used to bite her nails all the time. So she started wearing bright red nail polish. She bought the really expensive kind. So she felt that she had made an investment in quitting her bad habit. I think the polish made her think about what she was doing, too. Anyway, after a few months, it worked, and she has really nice nails now. I guess if you're a guy, it's a little more difficult, though.
Maybe you could find something else to do when you're stressed out, like tapping your fingers or counting to 100. You have to try to transfer your habit into a different activity, one that doesn't cause such a problem.
Three.
Okay, so, A, count instead. Yes or not? Julian, eight, was mentioned or not? ¿Fue mencionada o no fue mencionada, Julián? Write in the chat, please. Okay, Julián, you don't know. Sofía Velasco. Was mentioned or not?
¿Cómo?
¿Fue mencionada o no fue mencionada? La A, count instead. No? Yes? What?
Recuerdo.
Okay, you don't remember. Sara Giselle, count instead.
I don't know. No?
No. But if you listen again, let's listen again.
How to cause such a pride to transfer your habit into a different activity, one that doesn't cause such a problem. Something else to do when you're stressed out, like tapping your fingers or counting to 100.
¿Qué dijo? Counting to 100. ¿Contar hasta cuánto?
Hasta 100.
Hasta 100. Entonces, yes, was mentioned. ¿Listo? B, wear gloves. Yes or not?
Yes.
Yes. Where, Sara? ¿Qué dijeron de los gloves? Sara, ¿qué dijeron de los globes? Okay, but no, Sara. Let's listen again. Let's listen again.
An investment in quitting her bad habit. I think the polish... My sister used to bite her nails all the time, so she started wearing bright red nail polish. She bought the really expensive kind, so she...
¿Qué dijo? ¿Qué dijo? A ver, ¿quién me puede decir? Vamos a escuchar otra vez.
My sister used to bite her nails all the time, so she started wearing bright red nail polish. She bought the really expensive kind, so she felt that she had made an investment in...
Entonces, ¿cómo fue? Otra vez, vamos a escuchar otra vez.
Find out what's making you nervous. Once you've identified that problem and then solved it, the nail biting will disappear.
My sister used to bite her nails all the time, so she started wearing bright red nail polish. She bought the really expensive kind, so she felt that she had made an investment in quitting her bad habit.
Entonces, ¿qué dice? ¿Qué comenzó a qué? She started wearing bright red nail polish. Vamos a ver las mujeres. ¿Qué es nail polish? Lo voy a escribir ahí en el chat. ¿Qué es nail polish? Nail polish. Las mujeres, ellas deben saber. Nail polish.
¿Esmalte?
Esmalte. Very good. Entonces, la sugerencia de ella fue... Paint your nails. Paint your nails. ¿Listo? And D, figure it out why you're nervous. Yes or not? ¿Estaba o no estaba?
Yes.
Yes. At the beginning, the first person spoke about it. Okay? Now, the third one, how to organize your busy schedule. ¿Cómo organizar el horario? Vamos a ver.
I think the polish made her think about what she... And she has...
...her fingers or counting to a... One that doesn't cause such a problem.
...your busy schedule.
Ahí fue.
To organize a busy schedule, one thing you could do is make a list. I usually make a list of all the things I have to do. Then I prioritize them. Then I decide which days I'm going to get the things done based on which errands are the most important.
Maybe you could use electronic reminders. Put all the things you need to do into your calendar on your phone or your email. Then program it so you have reminders sent to you. For some things, you might get a reminder 15 minutes before, but for other things, it might be better to get a reminder a few hours or even days before. I use that to help me remember people's birthdays.
Okay. If your schedule is really busy, it might be a good idea to get help. There are plenty of professional consultants who organize people's lives. It's expensive, but if you're too busy, it's the only way to get everything done.
Excellent. So, program your phone. Yes or no?
Yeah.
With reminders. With reminders, yes. Make a list of priorities.
Yes.
Cancel appointments.
No.
Talk to a consultant.
Yes.
Excellent with the listening activity. Sarah and Karen, they actually participated, you know. So that's really good. So we made this really good, guys. Continue. Let's play again. We want to play a lot. Let's go for the play. Let's play. Entonces, les traje una canción. I brought you a song. A song that is new. Es una canción que es nueva. Y gracias a la infinidad de coincidencias que existen, la canción utiliza esta palabra que estamos manejando ahora, que es All You Have to Do. Se llama Stay, de Alexia Cara. Do you know the song? Sara, do you know the song?
No, teacher.
Karen, do you know the song?
No.
Sofia, do you know the song? Sofia, do you know the song? Sophie, are you here? Not. Sofía Velasco, ¿me escuchas? Okay, Sofía Velasco no me está. Bueno, entonces, durante la canción van a haber unas preguntas del tema que acabamos de ver, the grammatical part. So, let's go for it. ¿Están escuchando?
Yes.
Okay.
Waiting for the time to pass you by. Hope the winds of change will change your mind. I could give a thousand reasons.
Entonces, I could, should, or would. O again. Lo hacemos de nuevo.
Again.
Again. Let's just.
Waiting for the time to pass you by. Hope the winds of change will change your mind. I could give a thousand reasons.
What? Which one? Could, should, or would? It's una suggestion.
Cool.
Good. Excellent. Bingo. Very good, Sarah.
Reasons why, and I know you, and you've got to make it on your own. We don't have to grow up, we can stay forever young.
Entonces, we stay forever young. ¿Cómo sería? ¿O lo repetimos? Repeat it.
Yeah, repeat it.
Let's repeat it.
Get on your own, but we don't have to grow up. We can stay forever young. Living on myself.
¿Cómo? ¿Cómo es la palabra? We stay forever young. We qué?
We
qué?
Meet.
Ah, ¿puedes escribirlo en el chat, por favor? Write it in the chat, please. Karen Sofía, write it in the chat. Knit. Okay, let's write knit. Okay, the answer is can. Can. Listo, vamos a volverlo a escuchar.
And I know you. And you got to make it on your own, but we don't have to grow up. We can stay forever young.
So, we can stay forever young. ¿Listo? We can stay forever young. ¿Qué significa? Podemos estar siempre young.
Jóvenes.
Jóvenes, ok. Entonces lo dice él a la, al, al novio.
Living on my sofa, drinking rum and cola underneath the rising sun. I could give a thousand reasons why.
Entonces, I give, I que. Or repeat.
Repeat.
Let's repeat.
So far, drinking rum and cola underneath the rising sun. I could give a thousand reasons why.
I give you a thousand reasons why. ¿Qué dice?
Can?
Can. Vamos a escribir. Can. It says it's could. I could give you a thousand reasons why. Vamos a escucharlo otra vez. I could give you a thousand reasons why. Entonces, I could give you. ¿Listo? Yo podría. ¿Listo? Más que decir yo puedo, yo podría, porque es que sugerencia, suggestion. Recuerda que estamos estudiando hoy suggestions. Continue. ¿Qué? ¿Cómo dice? Entonces, hay tres espacios que hay que completar.
All to stay.
All to stay. ¿Quién más vota por esa? ¿Quién vota por on to play?
Yo, all to stay.
All to stay. ¿Quién más? ¿Quién más? Sofía. Sofía está aquí. Sofía. Where are you, Sofía? Entonces, Sofía. Por ahí está volviendo a entrar, Sofía. Let's wait for Sofía. Okay. Entonces, ¿qué dijeron? All do stay o on do play?
All do stay.
Entonces, ¿me lo podías leer completo, porfa, la 4?
All you have to do is stay.
All you have to do is stay. Todo lo que tienes que hacer es quedarte. Very good. Bingo.
A minute, just take your time. The clock is ticking, so stay. All you have to do is...
Entonces, tap and correct the wrong word. Entonces, ¿cuál es la palabra incorrecta? All you have to wait is wait. ¿Cuál es la correcta? ¿Cuál es la incorrecta, digo?
Wait.
¿Pero cuál? ¿Este al lado del to o al lado del is?
Lado del to.
Lado del to. ¿Y qué tendríamos que poner ahí? Ah. All you had qué?
Do.
all you had to do. Yes. Excellent. Excellent.
All you have to do is wait a second. Your hands on my. The clock is ticking, so stay.
Entonces, ¿cuál? We stay forever young.
¿Por?
We could. ¿Qué dice Karen?
O can.
Could.
Could and can. Ya, ya estás atrás. Sofía. Can you listen to me, Sofía? Sofía, okay, Sofía. Sofía, ¿me escuchas?
Yes.
Okay, entonces, ¿cuál votas? ¿Can o could? ¿O lo repetimos?
Yes, 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 yes.
Okay, let's repeat it. ¿Listo? We can stay forever young or we could stay forever young?
Can.
Can. Muy bien. Can. Listo.
Stay forever young. Living on my sofa, drinking rum and cola underneath the rising sun. I could give a million reasons why.
¿Cómo? Entonces, I could give you million reasons why.
Good time.
Okay, ¿quién más? Sofía. Or repeat it, Sofía, lo repito. Bueno, muchachos, en menos de un minuto, en less than a minute, la clase va a terminar. Entonces, pasamos al último descansito y volvemos. ¿Listo? A la cuarta.
¿De cuántos minutos, teacher?
15.
Okay.
Okay, so we are ready to finish the class. So we are in the seventh question. Estamos en la pregunta 7, okay? Para que no nos vayamos a olvidar.